Nicole, and I'm living my life by design. And y'all have seen Serena before.
Hi.
Hi. You can tell by the title of this video, we are talking about what items you should bring to flight attendant training. So let's just go ahead and jump right on into this. So first, we're just going to go over a few of the items that we think are necessary for you to bring to training, which are either going to just help you out throughout the training process, keep you comfortable, or help you stay fed, basically. So for our airline that's very near and dear to my heart, honestly, you don't really need to bring a lot of things because they really, really do set you up for success. It's like a hotel and they provide everything. All you really need to bring are your clothes. But for other airlines that don't have their own facility for their in-flight trainees or whatever departments that they're training, I hear that you might need to bring quite a few more items, so we're gonna just talk about those.
I would say bring like a pillow or blanket that's like, is just comforting for you to sleep with, because some airlines will put you in a hotel and that's not always homey. A lot of airlines, their trainings can be more than 4.5 weeks.
So, you know, you're gone for long periods of time and you're not necessarily getting to go back home. So, yeah, definitely bringing a blanket from home that is just comfortable and, you know, makes you feel homey. Maybe some photographs of family members or things like that.
I also wish that I would have, like, written a letter to myself about how excited I was for training and how much I wanted the job. Because sometimes, like, you might have, like, a little meltdown because it's overwhelming.
Absolutely.
And it's hard.
Absolutely. So like a little motivational letter.
Yeah, you're gonna be stressed out.
Yeah, just like a little remind you of why you're doing this. Yeah, yeah, absolutely. I agree with that too, because you know, you do get there, you're super excited that month before you get your training date or whenever you get your training date, and you're all hyped up and yes, I'm finally getting there and I'm going. And then you get there and then reality sinks in that, you know, it's not all fun and games and training. I'm not going to say it's not fun, because we had fun. We definitely had fun. But there's a lot of seriousness to it as well. I mean, it's intense at the end of the day. It's very intense. And you know.
Everyone's on the edge.
Everyone
wants to pass and graduate and get their wings.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. So just having something, you know, to remind you of why you're doing it, I think is a really good idea. I never thought about doing that, but boom, there you go. Even if it's just like postcards that you stick on the bathroom mirror or just whatever little motivational notes you can do for yourself to remind you of your goal. So training doesn't, you know, beat you down. It's tough, y'all. Training's tough.
I'd also say be consistent. Like, if you are a person that it helps if you're stressed out or if we're to like help you wake up or something, like to go to the gym, like be consistent and go every day at like a certain time.
Yeah, absolutely.
One of our classmates would take her study notes and just walk on the treadmill the whole time.
That was Kat.
Yeah,
I used to see her in the gym all the time doing that.
Yeah.
Yeah, Kat did that like every morning. I went to the gym a lot actually during training also. That was really just my relaxed time. I read my notes a little bit sometimes during the gym, but I more so went and just have some downtime and just like get my brain off of training.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think if you're overthinking training, you're gonna lose your mind.
I would go if I couldn't sleep and I had to be up really early in the morning.
Yeah. So definitely bring workout clothes, because a lot of people think that you don't have downtime during training, and you do. At least for the way our training program was set up, our classes were about 10 to 12 hours a day. I was in the PM class. We were both in PM, but you still have time to do things for yourself.
Yeah.
So not necessarily saying you can leave the training facility and go off and do whatever, maybe on your off day, yeah, sure, but you know, we were PM, so we went to class about 12 PM every day. So I usually wake up about 6, 7 AM. So between that time to 12 PM, I could do whatever I wanted with that time. So I'll probably take about an hour out of that time to study, eat some breakfast, work out, like whatever. So definitely bring some workout clothes if you're into to working out or whatever form of relaxation it is that you do, meditation, yoga. Bring whatever it is that you need to be able to practice that. As far as like notebooks or things like that, I did go shopping for training and I bought like 2 or 3 notebooks. I bought flashcards and sticky notes.
They provided us with notebooks though, and like write and fill in the blank kind of stuff. They provide us with pens, folders to keep all of our work together.
Yeah. Honestly, I didn't really need any of the things that I bought. And once again, that is the airline that we train for. They really, 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 really do set you up for success. So I used one notebook just simply because I didn't want to waste my money. I bought it. I'm going to use it. Mm-hmm. And that was my way. I just wrote notes in class to stay awake, honestly, because I never went back and read those notes once, because they also provided you with the PowerPoint printout of everything that they talked about. So you didn't really need it. But
oh yeah, I forgot about that.
Yeah,
and you can make anything. Little notes on the side of each PowerPoint instead of writing everything down the whole time. Yeah.
I would bring my laptop. I brought my laptop. Some people did, some people didn't. Obviously, there's probably computers at your training facility there for you to use. And we had CBTs, which is basically like online homework that we had to do. I was glad that I brought my laptop because I could just go back to my room and do it from there. But if you didn't have your own personal computer, you would have to be in the computer labs, computer rooms, whatever, and waiting for a computer or just in there with everybody else. And
some people are talking and kind of obnoxious about it. It's distracting.
Not kind of obnoxious, like really obnoxious. So, you know, if you have your own mindset that you like to do when you're studying, and if you don't want any distractions, bring your own computer. And if you're like Fawn, who wanted to order everything and receive boxes during training, and you know, Amazon and up, bring your own computer so you can order things, you can have things delivered to the training facility for you. And then that kind of just rolls into like grocery shopping. So once again, the airline near and dear to my heart, they hooked us up. We ain't have to grocery shop. There was no need, honestly, to go grocery shopping. Everything was right downstairs for us. We had an amazing kitchen downstairs, breakfast, lunch, dinner. And I mean, the food was great. You always had a different meal. You weren't really getting bored. They had healthy options. They had pretty much anything you wanted.
They had comfort food.
Yeah.
They knew when we were all stressed out.
Yeah.
They knew all of our names.
Absolutely. And then they also had like a little snack bar area as well. So, you know, if you're a candy eater like me or whatever you needed, they had it there. But mm-hmm. for those of you that are going to training with other facilities, most other airlines put you in a hotel. And it's usually like a comfort suite hotel where it's a full workup, like, you know, a little mini house. You have your kitchen, you have your fridge, you have all of that that you need right there in your hotel room. So you will need to go grocery shopping and buy whatever foods it is that you want to eat and things like that. So I wouldn't necessarily say bring that to training. Probably once you get there, you'll probably have a day or so to get yourself settled and comfortable. Go grocery shopping or order on Amazon. Let them deliver to you. I mean, all these grocery stores now, they have their own delivery methods. So
I think Walmart is starting to deliver too.
I think so.
And you can use Instacart as well.
Instacart. That's going to be one of the apps that we talk about a little bit later. What else do you need to bring to training? I just feel like we were set up so well that I'm just like,
I mean, they provided like shampoo and conditioner.
Yeah.
Towels. A laundry basket.
Mm-hmm. Literally, we had
a desk.
Everything.
Even like something to stick notes in on top of the desk.
I never used that, but that was there. I mean, you're just going to want to bring those basic things, though. Like, obviously, your own toiletries, makeup for the ladies if, you know, you're into makeup.
I brought, like, 5 business outfits, and then I just switched pieces up because I was not about to bring, like, three giant pieces of luggage.
That was me. I honestly, I overpacked because I don't know. I just have an issue with rewearing clothes mentally. It's like I have a mental block on it. But for training, if I were to go back to another training, I would definitely pack differently. I would just pack way less than what I brought. Like Serena says, maybe 5 pair of different dress pants. For training, usually you have to be in business casual wear. So a nice dress slack or a crop pant.
Like 3 pants, a skirt, and a dress.
Mm-hmm.
And then I brought like several blouses. Like some girls, they brought like a ton of dresses, but like going out and like nightclub dresses, like thinking that it was gonna be like, oh, I'm gonna go to class, I'm gonna go out after, but it's not like that because we were in a PM class. We weren't done until like sometimes like 2 a.m. or something crazy.
Yeah, we had late nights, midnight. We saw midnight quite a few times. Just far as like clothes to bring to wear during class time, bring a few slacks or skirts or whatever's more comfortable for you. Tops, usually classrooms are cold, so maybe a cardigan, you know, to keep you warm, a blazer or whatever. For the guys, you're just gonna bring chino pants, belt, button-up shirts, like call it a day, you know. Even a polo style shirt should be fine. Mm-hmm. You know, just it's, you don't have to be suited and booted. You just need to look like you're going into a business casual professional setting. End of story. Shoes. Weren't allowed to. Well, it depended. Like if we were in a just like the sit down classroom setting, we could technically have open toe shoes. I never wore open toe shoes to class.
Either.
It was just like a waste of time because
if you were on the flight simulator.
Yeah, if we were like on the simulator, like on the actual the plane, you can't wear open-toed shoes. So if you wore open-toed shoes to class and then you were going to do the simulator training, you would have to change your shoes. So to me, that was just silly to even wear them. But yeah, definitely bring flats. Like there's really no point in bringing a lot of heels. Maybe 1 pair of heels to wear with your uniform once you get to put that on and try that on. And you need to be uniform compliant.
Mm-hmm.
But walking around in heels all day?
It was not good. Once they told us that we can just wear flats to class, a ton of us ran over to Target and got these plain black belly flats. I still have mine.
I have mine too. I'm gonna buy some new ones though.
I might buy some like Skechers or something.
Like I literally had, I think, 3 pair of shoes, maybe 2. I had 2 black flats, had another pair of flats or whatever. But everything, and I like black, so everything I pretty much wore was black and white. Or some type of mixture of black and white. And that was it.
Yeah, I think I only wore my heel. I wore 2 different types of heels. And then just the black flats that we all got.
What else can you bring to training? I did bring a Yeti cup. I remember I walked around every day with that Yeti cup. Just to like stay hydrated and keep drinking water.
Mm-hmm.
That I did bring. So if you have like a coffee mug or a tea canister or whatever it is that, like, that would be good to bring because, you know, just buying water bottles all the time can get expensive for one and just...
Yeah, I had a Swell bottle.
Yeah.
But, and it does the same thing, keeps it hot or cold, but it's just handy to have, and except I lost mine on a Delta plane.
Oh!
I have to get a new one.
Yeah, that was definitely one thing that I brought, and I was really glad that I brought it because every morning I would just go down into the kitchen, fill it up with water. On our breaks, I would go back, fill it up again, and it just keeps you hydrated like you should be.
Bring lots of tights or stockings depending on if you like to wear skirts or dresses or pants.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know a lot of girls who had tights, they kept ripping, so have backup.
Absolutely. Because I wore my tights hosiery every day. One, because it was cold, and 2, because I wanted to get used to just having them on because you have to wear them with uniform. And then 3, I wore them if I had cropped pants. If I had cropped pants that like stuff right here, don't mind my socks and tights, y'all. I have a tattoo on my ankle, so I would always have to have that covered.
And you had like really dark tights, right?
I wear like the really dark opaque tights.
Yeah,
so
if you have tattoos, get the black ones, not the sheer ones.
Yeah.
Because if you have a tattoo on top of your foot and your heels aren't covering it.
Yeah. Yeah. Just be careful about those things, y'all. Oh, yeah. And medicine. Almost forgot this. Oh. I went to training with a full bag full of every medicine that you could need for any kind of sickness. So
I take vitamins every day.
Yep.
A vitamin C tablet every day.
I had the 800 milligram ibuprofen. I had Band-Aids. You know, ladies, don't forget your tampons and your pads. You're going to need those, obviously, because your cycle's going to come. You know, just the little things that you say, oh, I can run out to the store to go get. But you never know that day that that might drop on you. You might not have time to go run out to the store and get it. So just have it with you already. Don't forget to bring a watch. Bring a watch to training. Not sure what your airline requires or does not require. When we started training, watches were required. They no longer are. That's a whole nother story. But just bring it anyway.
Bring your black bag that you'll probably use while you're a flight attendant to keep all your class supplies in.
Yeah.
And your water bottle and just things that you're going to need throughout the day.
Yeah, absolutely.
Something to have your snacks
in. A nice size bag to carry around with you. Because even though our classroom and our hotel are literally
connected,
like a 2-minute walk across the street. We didn't really have a lot of time to go up to our room for everything we needed. Like, nobody has time for that. So
they just had a little kitchenette with vending machines and a coffee.
Yeah.
But yeah, I would always like go to the grocery store on our day off, and then I'd have stuff in my room that I could just throw into my bag. Like granola bars and pretzels. And then candy from the one I collected from our stipend.
Yeah, I think that's pretty much it as far as what you should bring to training. And I'm sure your airline's going to send you a list of things that you need.
They're very thorough.
Yeah, so bring that. If you're getting ready to go to training, good luck. I just came back from the airline that's very near and dear to my heart. We had some in-flight graduate this past Friday. Congratulations to all of you.
I just worked with a baby blue. She's been in it for a month.
Did you? Mm-hmm. Oh, I just love them. So yeah, congratulations to you all. Hope those tidbits about what you need to bring to training are helpful. Until next time, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Thank you.